speaker this evening is John Slepka. John Slepka, focus. Focus. John Slepka. Focus. What do you think of when you hear the word focus? Do you picture a world-class athlete like Michael Jordan stepping back behind the three-point line and receiving the pass with 1 second left, fading away, hitting that game-winning shot? Focus. Or perhaps you picture a pitcher, or a camera, or a cameraman, or maybe the baseline photographer at that Chicago Bulls game focusing in on Michael Jordan hitting that game-winning shot. Focus. I suspect, though, that you don't picture a middle-aged man at the county fair screaming at his kid, "Let's go!" Mr. Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters, and guests, I was that middle-aged man at the Monmouth County Fair, of all places, the exact last place that I would ever expect to learn a very valuable life lesson, especially one as impactful as the power of focus. A few years ago, my wife and I were on Kozlowski Road in Freehold, going past the county fairgrounds, when we saw the blinking sign, County Fair, this weekend. Kids race day, Saturday. Check the back seat. I got two kids in tow. Honey, did you see the sign? What sign? Kids race day sign. Oh yeah, the kids race day sign. What's kids race day? I don't know. A quick Google search on her phone let us know that my son would be competing in the toddler waddle. And my daughter was going to be eligible for the big wheel rally. So that Saturday, we showed up at 9 a.m. at the county fair, and it was 100 degrees out. And if it wasn't really 100 degrees, it was 95 and sticky. And if you're from New Jersey, you know what I'm talking about. A really hot, hot summer morning. Now, my kids had been at the county fair the year before, and they knew all about the ice cream, the rides, the games, the ponies, the big, giant watermelons. They were focused on all of these things. Everything except kids' race day. So I was able to corral them over, promising them that we'll do all of that as soon as we're done, knowing full well that it was hot. We weren't gonna stick around. But I was excited. I was trying to get them excited. So there, my wife, Courtney, and I were trying to get my son, Jax, ready for the race. Buddy, this is what you do. This is gonna be your lane. These are all the kids that you're racing against. That's the finish line down there. You're gonna, as soon as they say go, run as fast as you can. On your marks, get set, go! And with that, kids went in every single direction. My wife had her camera. I went running down. There's a great picture of me. My son looking over his shoulder. By the time I got to the finish line, he was back hugging his mom. And I realized what just happened. Hashtag parental fail. I was determined not to let my daughter suffer the same fate. I was focused on helping her focus on where she needed to go. How could I expect a kid to know what a finish line was? Right at about the same time that I realized what I needed to do, she started focusing herself on the giant ribbon that the toddler waddle winner was getting. A ribbon nearly twice the size as he was. And she became obsessed. Daddy, daddy, how do I get one of these ribbons? I want one of these ribbons. Honey, calm down. You need to race. You need to win a couple races, and then you could get a ribbon. You can get this ribbon, but you really have to focus, and I'm gonna go down to the end, and I'm just gonna let's go, let's go. And you're gonna remember grandma and grandma's house with the big wheel, yeah? You're gonna go as fast as you can, you're gonna get to me. She won the first heat, then she won her semifinal heat. Now, the thought of this ribbon consumed her. She was more than obsessed. She was like, I gotta have it. I said, you have one more race. All you have to do is win one more race. And she blew the boys away. They didn't stand a chance. She got this big ribbon. And I'm beaming, I'm just smiling, and at that point, I realized, at that point, what I had seen. Hashtag, my next Toastmaster speech. We've all been there, I'm sure. The word focus actually just jumped out. I saw the letters, and I was like, yes, an acronym. I love acronyms. The letters were clear as day. F, find a goal, or a focal point. Focal point is actually the definition of focus. So her goal at the time was this ribbon. And she became, obsessed about it. Now, we hear the word obsession, and a lot of times it's negative, but I believe that if you have a worthwhile goal, why not obsess about it? And what's wrong with having a county fair, big ribbon? C, consume. You need to obsess about your goal until it consumes you. And that's what it did for my daughter. It's the last thing you think about when you go to bed. It's the first thing you think about in the morning. You don't need a snooze behind your alarm clock because you're fired up and you go to work every single day. It consumes you. And you urge. I'm a salesperson, so I do a lot of self-urging, but I urge you to get some urging, some mentors, some coaches. Toastmasters is great for that. A parent, a significant other, somebody to hold you accountable and speak positive thoughts to you and positive words to you. But all of that doesn't matter until you S, start. Ancient Chinese proverb said that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Tony Robbins talks about change happening in an instant. You could go years and years and years with the right goal, the right obsession, the right consumption, the right people urging you along, but until you start, nothing is going to happen. So, fellow Toastmasters, before I let you go, I got a couple bonus S's for you, because I love bonuses as much as I love acronyms. So bonus S number one, stake your claim. You're not always going to win, but you can learn a lesson. The miners in 49 didn't go to California hoping to get all the gold. They'll have to get some of the gold. So stake your claim. And then once you get it, S, bonus S number two, share the wealth. It may not always be money. On that Saturday morning, it was the smile of a six-year-old little girl and the good feeling that she brought the family. And yeah, we stuck around that fair. We wanted to show off that ribbon. And 6 years later, I'm still sharing the story because it was so impactful for me. So, doesn't matter where you are, soccer field, the grocery store, or the county fair. Slow down, keep your eyes open, and life will show you how to focus.
Congress, can we have him down the clock, please?